Hello everyone, welcome to Elite Engineer. In this video, we are going to see how we can model our wind turbine system for 5 kilowatt. Basically, before starting this video, I will say if you are designing any kilowatt of your system or wind turbine, that is either of 100 kilowatt also. After watching this and performing the calculations with me, you can even design any kilowatt rating of wind turbine system. So let's see how we can model. So before starting, I will say if you are not subscribed to our channel yet, please subscribe because most of our subscribers are just watching without subscribing, please. So let's begin. So there are some equations like output power of the turbine, CP and 1 by lambda I and the lambda that I've taken from some research paper. If you want, I will just put in the comment section so that you can access these all equations. Basically in these equations, like output power of the turbine, we already know my output power, how much rating of turbine I want to design. Like I want to design for 5 kilowatt, that means 5000 watt. So this power I already know. Whereas this coefficient like CP, which is a function of lambda and beta, I don't know. Rho, which is air density, I know it's same 1.225, is a constant. And A is my area, how much my wind blades are being swept. Like it's pi r square. And VW is my wind speed. Basically, wind speed, which we are considering of 12 meters per second at every instant of time. Whereas in most of the research papers, they're taking at 9 to 12. That means we are varying between 9 to 12. And so many people are also considering 50. I don't know why they are taking that wind speed to very high value. I thought for getting some outputs, desired outputs. So let's see how we can design for 5 kilowatt system. So basically, I'll just modify this only. See, here power is 5000. And here half I'll type because this part is half a constant directly. You have to perform calculations with me if you are calculating some parameters for the wind turbine. Now what I want, I have to find one CP. Okay, now I'll type here CP because I need to find CP. Then what I need to find is I know the value of rho, that is around 1.225. I will just type here 1.225. At the end I will see what are the parameters that I need to find. Okay, then it's pi r square. Area is what? Pi r square into r. What is r? Radius I need to find. So pi r square I'll type. And then what else? It's 12. 12 cube. Okay. It's 12 cube. 12 cube. Fine. So in this I need to find r and cp. Okay. So now how to find this r and cp? Now these I have two equations. First is this cp equation where I need to find lambda I is also I want. So for this, first I will go to lambda I. After finding lambda I, I will just put my lambda I here and will find CP. Okay, and then I will just directly go to this value, first one, and then directly to the fourth one. Like this fashion I will go. So after calculating all the values, what I got is my CP. I told first lambda I we have to calculate. So after calculating lambda I got 11.304. That lambda I have fed to equation number 2 and I got my CP as 0.41034. That CP I have fed it here, like I have CP now. Okay, and from here I can calculate R, which R I got as a radius that is swept by the blades of wind turbine is 1.91431. okay, and then this R, which is fed to this fourth equation, R I know, VW we know, and from there we can calculate WW. Now this is a speed which is equal to 50.775. this all we have now, and we can verify these parameters while designing in MATLAB. So let's go to MATLAB. So for designing the system in MATLAB, what we want is, first of all, we want our parameter like subsystem. So we want to carry everything in this subsystem so that from outside we can put our parameters like what is the value of radius, what is the wind speed in meters per second, and so on. Okay, first of all, I'll just remove this. I'll make this in this side and this one to this corner. So this is my PM. We already know first we have to design our first equation. Okay, this is our first equation, that is PM, output power, which is equal to half of CP lambda B into rho into A into VWQ. So for this I need half. So I'll just take one constant. Okay, I'll just take one constant, and otherwise we can take, instead of constant, as a gain we can take. Okay, because we need to multiply this. I will take that gain and I will just put this gain value to be half, 1/2. Yeah, now this gain is multiplied with this. Now with this I need one multiplication block. Okay, I need multiplication. Now, this I need to multiply by Cp, rho, A and wind speed, Q. Now, I have four parameters, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now, I'll go directly here. I need four parameters. I'll just take it four. I will just increase its size and yeah, it's fine. And now I need first one, which is my A. I'll double click here. I will just write so that I will not forget and I will know what parameters I need to add in future. And this is our wind cube, V cube. Okay. And next one is my air density, which is my rho, air density. And last one is my Cp. Okay. Last one is my Cp. Now I need area. For this, I know what is my area. I already told last time that area we are taking as pi r square. So I need pi. Now how to add that pi? I'll make one constant block again. Okay, I'll just take this same block. I will make this pi. Okay, this pi I will add it here. 1 minute. Yeah. I'll just take it here, this side. Now I need, now this I have added. Now this r will be multiplied. Now this r will be multiplied by this. So I need some function block also. FCN, I need function. Okay. So this, in this function, what I will do is I'll write one expression. Now what expression I need? See, I will take some resistor, that is a radius, from input, and that I'll feed to this, which will become pi r square. So here I need to feed u1 square, because in input I will feed one radius. So this is my radius, which is in meters. Okay, so this radius I'll feed here to this, which will become square and it will multiply by pi, and this will become our area. Okay, this is fine. Now this is fine. Now we can progress to wind velocity, which is equal to our V cube. Here, what is our V cube? So now V cube also we need to feed from input. Now what I will do is I will just take same one so that I can take from input these parameters. 1 minute, system got hang. Yeah, it's fine now. Now I need this V W meters per second. Okay, meters per second. Yeah, now I'll connect this block with something so that it can become Q. Now similar function, I need some function block again. Yeah, and I'll just connect the wind speed with this. Now I need the cube of this. Instead of 2, just replace this by 3 so that it will become Q. Now I need air density factor. We know air density factor is what? 1.225. I need one constant block to feed it 1.225, which will feed to this side. 1 minute. Yeah, 1.225. Now I need one Cp. Now this is a main. How we can design our Cp? So for designing Cp, we know that we are having this formula. C1 C2 by lambda I, C3 into beta minus C4. Now this all equations I need to write. How I need to write? I'll show you. For this, I need again one subsystem. So in this subsystem, what I have to do is, this is what my Cp. I'll write here Cp. Now this Cp will have to be multiplied by something like these all other parameters. This has to be multiplied to get the Cp. For this, what I need is, I want here my function block, which I have used previous case. Okay, I need one function block here. This function block should have two inputs. Why? Because Cp, which we are taking here, has two constant like lambda I and beta. All other parameters value I know, which I already told that it is given in the paper. C1 to C6 are constants. Okay, so I will tell how I am feeding this. Now I'll just open this. Now I need some expression for Cp. Now what expression I need to type here? So this value I will take here, and this one I will directly come here. Yeah, this is fine. Now I need to type here, like first is C1. What is C1? Let's see, scroll it. C1 is 0.5. okay, so here I will write 0.5 multiplication with what is next parameter? C2 by lambda I. Okay, C2 is my 116 into, now I need lambda I, 1 by lambda I. So 1 by lambda I, I'll feed from input. So I will take this as U1 minus of C3. What is C3? C3 is 0.4. C3 is 0.4. And beta also I will feed from input. Multiplication with U2, because that is the second which I will feed. Okay. Then minus of what I have done? This is my first, this is my second, and this will be my beta. Now C4. What is my C4? This 1, 2, 3, and 4. C4 is 0. C4 is 0. And then I will feed this to C5. Yeah, this beta is 0. Then minus C5. So that is minus of 5. Minus 5. Because this one, C5, is 5 in this case. And then multiplication with exponential of, what is this last one parameter? It is minus C6 by lambda I. Minus C6. What is last one? 21. Which is equal to minus 21 by U1. So multiplication I will do, because 1 by lambda I am taking as input. So this is over. So let's verify whether everything is fine here. Yeah, it is fine. I hope it will not give any error. Yeah, this is fine. Now this function I have just made. Now I'll see what I want. So in this, I want my two inputs, U1, U2. I just put one mux. Mux. Okay, I need one mux. This I'll feed it here. And then I need my two inputs. One is lambda. L-A. MBDA lambda, and another one I need beta, paste beta, and this one I need to feed it here. One is my lambda and one is my beta. This one is lambda and this one is beta. This I will feed, and one more I need one block, because this is my U1 and this is my U2. Okay, this one is my U1 and this one is my U2. Okay. So this one was my lambda and this one was my beta. Now I need to establish a relationship, what I have made, which is equal to this. Also I need one function block. How to generate lambda? Okay, for this, which was, I'll show it here. 1 by lambda I know the equation of 1 by lambda I. Now this equation I will feed it here. I'll feed this equation here. Okay, now how I'll feed is 1 by u of 1 plus of 0.08 in product with u2, which is equal to beta, and then I'll just put it in bracket, otherwise it will cause some problem, because we need to use some addition and subtraction, it will create some confusion. Then it is 0.035, okay, divided by 1 plus, because this is what, 1 plus beta cube. Beta I have taken as, I know, second parameter, and cube of that. Okay, so this is perfectly done. Now this is U1 is correct. Now we can just progress it further. We'll connect it like this here. I have lambda, I have beta, U1, U2, which I'll feed it here. Now this one I have fed it to this parameter. Okay, this is basically what, my equation number 2. I'll just write, because confusion should not be there. EQUA equation 2. And this one is my equation number 3. EQUA equation number 3. Fine. And this U2 is my beta. So I'll feed it directly here. Okay, this is fine. And this is my U1, which is equal to lambda 1. This is my U2. If you want, I will just write, because confusion should not be there at the end. And this is my U1. And this is my U2. Okay, this is fine now. I have designed this. Now I'll go back. And I'll see what are the parameters that are required further. So this is my CP. This CP I'll feed it here. This CP I fed it here. Now I have CP. So beta I am feeding from input. So I just need one parameter like this. paste, and this parameter I will feed from input beta. Okay, I'll just write here beta. This parameter I'll feed from input. Now I need to create a lambda. So how to create the lambda? So in this I know that is equal to WR into radius into VW. So radius I already know. Okay, I'm feeding that from input. Then after that, that radius is multiplied. So I need one multiplication block. That I need to multiply with omega R. So I need one omega R also. Paste. So this one is my omega radians per second. Omega radians per second. Okay, so this will be product, and then what will happen is omega into R by wind velocity. So here one division will also come. Okay, I'll just double click. I'll just make it division. Now this will be how much? Wait, I'll just make it opposite. Yeah, this is fine now, because I need to product of this with the division of wind velocity. Now I need one saturation block also. Okay, you are a saturation block. Why it is not coming? Wait, I'll search it here. Otherwise I think some lagging issue is there in laptop. SATU saturation. Yeah, it came. So this is my saturation block. I'll take from here saturation, and I'll just add it here, my saturation, and which will be equal to infinity, and lower limit I will take as 1e minus 6. Okay, so this is my saturation. Now this one I will feed directly to my lambda, and here I will put one display so that I can verify the parameters which I have shown you in my word format, so that we can verify our lambda, what we got from simulation and what we are getting from there. Okay, and we are using this parameter basically because this should not saturate. If lower limit exceeds some value, it will become zero. So lambda should not go zero. Okay, for this value we are just using saturation block. So I'll just put one saturation here also, because if division, see, if division will become zero, this full system will, this will become infinity na. So if this will become infinity, our full system will get destroyed, man. There's no need of making some wind turbine also. For this, avoiding this condition, I'm using this saturation block. So all saturation blocks are same. Now I need to connect this here. Okay, why I'm taking this here is I have got power. Now I need to calculate torque. For calculation of torque, I know power divide by here power. Where is division one? This is our division. I'll just connect this together. This one, and this is my power. I will get here torque. Okay, I'll get here torque. Yeah, so this is my TM, torque. Here is my TM. Okay, this is my torque. So now I'll just verify. I have my radius, I have my wind speed, I have W, I have torque, I have power. So this one I need on the right hand side. Okay, this will come, and this is my beta. So let's verify. First we will put some display also, so that we can just see. Here also we can put one for power and one for the torque. Yeah, it is fine. Now we can go back and we can just see by putting our values. So I'll just make this little big, and I will just name this as 5 kilowatt wind turbine system. Okay, now this is our beta. Where is my beta? This is my beta. I'll just put one constant here. Beta value I'll just put at 0, and then our radius. What is the value of radius that we have calculated? We have calculated radius to be 1.91431. okay, this is my radius. Then what is the value of VW? Okay, so VW is our wind speed. So what is the wind speed? We have taken to be as 12, I already told you. And omega, that is in radians per second, what we have taken as. So omega in radians per second, we have got 50.775. okay, so I'll just feed this value here, 50.775. now I need power. For checking power, I need one more display. So 1 minute, what I'm doing, I have to just display, I am putting the constant block. Okay, so this is one display for power, and okay, I'll just type here for power, and this one is for torque. Torque. Okay, now we'll try to run this model. We'll see. I hope error should not come. Okay, power GUI is missing. Power GUI. Fine. Yeah, power GUI came. Yeah, now I'll run this model. I hope it will work. Compiling, we have to wait for compiling. Yeah, it came. So power came around 5 kilowatt, that is 5000 watts. So our system is perfectly working. I'm so happy with this, that our system is working perfectly. Now I will just make you that all the parameters which we have find is being same as that which is being displayed in MATLAB Simulink model. I am really shocked when I just first time I just simulated it. Okay, so lambda, it's coming 8.1. I already told in most of the research papers there is lambda that is 8.1, and that is what we have considered, that is 8.1. okay, see, this is a lambda what we have considered here for calculation purpose also. And then this is my CP. Okay, CP what we have calculated is 0.4103, 0.4105, almost same, 0.410, that is perfectly fine. And then if you want to calculate any parameter like this, we have to design any parameter like this, you can design. So I have made one system for 5 kilowatt of system, wind turbine system. So for your system, whatsoever you can model with this calculations, and you can follow my this full video step by step. With this you can design your own personalized wind turbine system. Thank you for watching this video, guys. If you are not subscribed to our channel yet, please hit the subscribe button. Thank you for watching this video.